Welcome back. Today we're going to experiment with Newton apples and discuss some of the core concepts of gravity. If you're unfamiliar with the story, one day Isaac Newton was sitting under an apple tree when one of the apples fell on his head. When the apple fell, he began to wonder why this happened. Newton realized that gravity is the force of attraction between two objects and that the object with more mass exerted a greater force. This means that because the Earth has a larger gravitational pull, the apple was pulled down towards it. However, the apple is also pulling on the Earth, just a lot less. But how do we measure force? Force is measured in newtons. One newton weighs 0.02248 pounds on Earth, or 102 grams. A newton is the force required to accelerate 1 kilogram at the rate of 1 meter per second squared. You may be asking yourself, what does a newton feel like? If you take one of the newton apples and extend your arm straight out in front of you, you'll be able to feel the force of 1 newton. Balancing the newton apples works in a similar sense. Objects that weigh the same will create balance, just like you see here. This is because both masses are exerting the same force. Scientists refer to this as balanced forces, or the apples having a net force of zero. If you were to tie, let's say, 500 gram weighted mass to the other end, you would see that the force becomes unbalanced and the apple rises. The opposite would happen if you were to use a paperclip. The apple pulls on the paperclip like it weighs nothing. This shows us that opposing forces that are equal create no change in movement, while opposing forces that are unbalanced create movement. But what happens when we incorporate another force, such as friction? For this part of the experiment, we're using a friction block, so we will attach a string to one end and the other end to one of the apples. Place the friction block on its smoothest side and dangle the apple off the side of the table. What do you notice? Because of the low friction surface, the apple pulls the block off the table. Now, turn the friction block to the sandpaper side and dangle the apple off the edge again. How is the movement changed? Since the sandpaper creates more friction, the block no longer moves. Friction is a force that opposes motion, so therefore we would need to add more apples, or force, to overcome it. So we've experimented with opposing forces, but how does gravity affect objects of differing weights? To find out, we'll attach two of the apples together and drop them at the same time as a single apple. Which one do you think will hit first? Wait, did you guess? Okay, back to the action. If you said they'd hit at the same time, you'd be right. Newton said that gravity acts on all objects the same amount, no matter their weight. So this means no matter how many apples you add, assuming there's no air resistance, they will reach the floor at the same time as a single apple because all objects fall at the same rate. Remember, gravity is the result of mass, and the mass of the Earth is constant, so it's always attracting other objects at that constant rate. Knowing this information, we can use a little math and calculate the acceleration due to gravity. You'll need a stopwatch and a tape measure for the next part. Start by measuring the position from the floor to the point where you'll be dropping the apple. This number represents the distance. With the stopwatch, start the time as soon as you release the apple and stop it at the moment it hits the floor. Now, drop the apple from your marked location. Repeat the drop at least 3 more times, then average the results. This will represent the time. Now, to figure out the acceleration, we can use the equation, acceleration equals 2 times the distance divided by time squared. Newton stated that on Earth, all objects fall at the same rate, which we call the rate of acceleration due to gravity. And as long as you are on Earth, it is 9.8 meters per second squared. If we were to travel to another planet or the moon, the rate of acceleration would be different because the masses of those planets are different. This means that if an object is in the air for 1 second, it's traveling at 9.8 meters per second. After 2 seconds, it's close to 20 meters per second. And after 3 seconds, it's going 30 meters per second. If you've done your calculations and measurements accurately, you will see that your results should have a similar rate. As we discussed earlier, because of the large mass of the Earth, the apple was pulled upwards towards it. Gravity is what helps to keep us on the ground, and not floating in space, and how planets remain in orbit. Okay, well that does it for the Newton-Apple experiment. If you enjoyed this experiment, be sure to subscribe. And if you have an idea for an experiment you'd like to see, let us know in the comments below. Until next time, have fun learning.